so near, while apart. I'm not alone in the night, when I can have all the love you are. I'm immortalized every night. And I kiss the name that you sign. And darling, then I'll meet again right from the start. Love letters straight from your heart. I'll memorize every line. And I kiss the name that you signed. And darling, then I read again right from the start. Love letters straight from your heart.
Please lock me away and don't allow the day here inside where I hide with my loneliness. I don't care what they say, I won't stay in a world without love. Birds sing out of tune and rain clouds hide the moon. I'm okay, here I'll stay with my loneliness. I don't care what they say, I won't stay in a world without love. So I wait, and in a while I will see my true love smile. She may come, I know not when. When she does, I'll know. So baby, until then, lock me away and don't allow the day here inside where I hide with my loneliness. I don't care what they say, I won't stay in a world without love. So I wait, and in a while I will see my true love smile. She may come, I know not when. When she does, I'll know. So baby, until then, lock me away and don't allow the day here inside where I hide with my loneliness. I don't care what they say, I won't stay in a world without love. I don't care what they say, I won't stay in a world without love.
Good evening and welcome to the OLA School Theater and our production of Dear Edwina Jr. Please remember no flash photography during the show. Also, please remain seated during the show. Enjoy.
Right now. I'm late for a very important meeting with my set designer, light designer, producer. Daddy!
What's with her?
Don't you know? Today she's coming.
Who's she?
Who's she? The town scout from the Kalamazoo Advice-a-Palooza Festival.
The Kalamazoo Advice-a-Palooza Festival?
It's only the biggest advice-giving convention ever.
I thought only famous people were accepted into the Kalamazoo Advice-a-Palooza Festival.
Didn't you hear? Due to Dr. Joyce Brothers, last-minute cancellation, there's one more spot available, and they may fill it with local talent.
That's us!
Whoa!
That's some of us.
Okay, everybody, I guess we're ready. Oh, please, please, please don't let anything go wrong today. I guess there's nothing else to do but say, break a leg, everybody. So, break a leg, everybody.
Oh!
What happened?
Get away from you, sluts.
What happened?
My ankle, my ankle! Oh, good! I just got my Girl Scouts first aid patch last week. I know CPR too.
Ah, get away from me! Oh, great. Just perfect. This had to happen on the day the Talent Scout is coming. Wherever are we going to find a last-minute replacement?
Hi, I'm Bobby, your new next-door neighbor. I moved here from St. Louis.
Great, can you sing? Can you dance?
Well...
You'll learn.
I just need to drop off these brownies for my mom.
Good luck out there, kiddo. You're coming out the new kid on the block, but you're coming back a star.
Be brave, Lars.
I stubbed my toe, Edwina.
I heard there's a kid my age who lives.
You must be thinking of my sister, Katie. She's at the Math Summer Olympics in Ypsilanti.
Oh, well, I heard the best piano player in town lives here. Do you give lessons?
You must be thinking of my sister, Myra. You can probably find her after the show.
Oh, well, then were you that drummer practicing earlier? You sound great.
That was my brother, Joe.
Well, who are you?
I'm Edwina Spoonapple, advice giver extraordinaire. Perhaps you've heard of me?
Not really.
Not really necessary. Now, Bobby, we'll just get you started on the opera and the big tap number. And you can't eat fire by chance, can you?
Fire?
Gee, Edwina, can't you see he doesn't want to do it?
It's okay. A little stage fright never hurt anyone. Oh, forget it. Hold the curtain. Take five, everybody. I have to go think about what to do.
Gee, Edwina, this is really important to you, isn't it?
You couldn't possibly understand. When Katie's good at math, she gets a big fat A. That's tacked up on my family's frigidaire. And at every music contest, Joe and Myra take the prize. On the freezer, there are ribbons everywhere. And I'm proud to be their sister, but it really makes me blue that there isn't any prize for telling people what to do. Except an invitation to Kalamazoo.
Kalamazoo?
Home of the world-famous Kalamazoo Advice-a-Palooza Festival. Do you know what an invitation could mean, Bobby?
No.
A chance to finally be where I belong. Up on the fridge is where I want to be, just like Katie and Myra and Joe. There's a white plastic magnet that's just the right size where my new invitation can go. And then every morning I'll open the door, get some OJ or milk, and I'll see what I dreamed of and wished for and hoped for and prayed for, a prize that belongs to me. My parents are proud, but they don't understand. You can't hold a pat on the back of your hand. But up on the fridge, how I long for the day I can point to the door and say, gee, there's Katie and Myra and Myra and Myra and Joe and Katie and Joe and me.
Well, what's everyone sitting around for? Let's get this show started. Direct from the beautiful downtown Paw Paw, Michigan, the Spoonapple Repertory Theater is proud to present their latest performance of their
First season!
As a courtesy to performers, we ask that no flash photography be used.
Keep that video camera rolling, Grandma!
And now, the advice giver extraordinaire, capable of solving problems of all shapes, sizes, and subjects, and... and undisputed queen of my heart.
Scott.
Sorry, our beautiful, wonderful, dear Edwina.
Roll out the bear of love, got news here. Who's made advice a stellar career? Even if it goes out of one ear, Edwina. If you believe your manners are scary, never you fear, here comes your good fairy. Brighter than the moon's glow, she knows where the spoons go. Write her a letter, she will reply. Then you can kiss your troubles goodbye. Wiser than owls and sweeter than pie is she. She'll fill your life with roses and clover. How can you help but go, God, over? Pressing etiquette questions.
She's on a field to make your suggestion.
Expert on all issues. Carries extra tissues. Beautiful queen of thank you and please. Take all our hearts, we'll give you the keys. You make the world a breezier place to be. Advice is such a sensation. Now it's the nicest week in the nation. All thanks to you. Gray skies are blue. Our love is true. Dear Edwina, dear Edwina.
Welcome to the Dear Edwina Advice Giving Show, written by me, Edwina Spoonapple. And for refreshment, don't forget to visit Kelly's Lemonade Stand during our 5-minute intermission. And I've just been informed that anyone from Kalamazoo, our great sister city to the west, will receive a free refill of Kool-Aid of his or her choice.
Here comes a letter for Edwina. Here comes a letter, birds of the lot. Here comes a letter for Edwina. Show us what you've got.
Just look at this wheelbarrow. It sure looks like you people of Pawpaw need a lot of advice. While the selection process was very difficult, we found some amazing, earth-shatteringly important topics for today's show. Things like...
Brothers and sisters.
Saving money. Setting the table.
True love. I mean, foods you don't like.
Ah, yes. Foods you don't like. Let's start with that. Dear Edwina,
my brother Aristotle, he's really very picky. Most foods we put upon his plate, he thinks very icky. He cries, he moans, he sighs, he hides under the table. Oh, your new friend, Aphrodite Colossus Sabina Swenson.
Aristotle Swenson, I know a lot of people like you, but you have to remember, if you want to be polite, it's not what you eat, it's what you say. If you don't believe me, just ask the famous rock group direct from the Pawpaw Community Center Battle of the Bands. Please welcome Susie and the Napkins.
Johnny looked like an angel in his suit and tie as he visited the Queen of Hula Hula.
Okay, well.
Of the manners that he learned in school, he greeted the Queen with a smile and bow, and he said, and the Queen was took a little taste of some tea, spicy, and very red. And it said,
say no thank you,
say no thank you,
say no thank you,
say no thank you.
If the soup leaves you cold, you should butter scold. Just say no thank you,
say no thank you,
say no thank you,
say no thank you.
Press the napkin to your chin, then breathe out and breathe in. For in many cases you'll find it's true, what's good to someone else may not taste good to you. So when that happens,
if that happens,
say no thank you. Don't pretend that you were choking. Don't fall down upon the floor. Simply smile and say no thank you. Don't go screaming out the door.
It's important
that you don't insult your host, but that doesn't mean you have to eat octopus toast.
Johnny, how about a little taste of octopus toast?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Say no thank you.
Say no thank you.
Say no thank you.
Say no thank you.
Take a teeny little bite. You taste no bite. Just thank you.
Say no thank you.
You
say no thank you.
Go to sleep, you're not. Peace is your fine, it's right, even. You can be polite, so when that happens, if that happens, say no thank you. When that happens, if that happens, say no thank you.
Peanut butter and jellies.
Wasn't that wonderful? Now, let's introduce the top of the cheerleading pyramid for the Pawpaw Wildcats. Let's hear it for Becky Del Vecchio.
My name is Becky, and it's nice to meet you. I have a lot of friends from Kalamazoo.
Thank you, Becky. Now, where were we?
Hey, all you people from Advice-a-Palooza Festival. When it comes to good advice, Edwina is the best of all.
Okay, then.
Hey, Kalamazoo, what do you think? Are you gonna pick us or do we stink? How good was that?
Moving on.
I made it up myself.
Hit it.
Another letter, a letter for Edwina. Another letter, what does it say? Another letter, a letter for Edwina. Help is on the way.
And to bring on the next letter, we have the president of the Paw Paw Bird Watching Society and chairman of the Michigan All-State Chess Club.
And the future Mr. Edwina Spoonapple.
And the designer of today's program, please welcome Scott Kunkel. Scott, the envelope, please. This is not the next letter. The next letter's in the blue one.
I like this one better.
But the blue one's the one we rehearsed. No. Thank you. Ooh, now this is what I call a problem.
Edwina, Edwina, I'm at the end of my rope. How do I stop my brother from acting like a dope? He makes disgusting noises and he snorts just like a pig. I like to punch the lights out, but I'm small and he's too big. My birthday party's coming and his grossness never ends. How do I have him there without losing all my friends? Sincerely, warmest wishes, Abigail, Matilda, Weckenheimer.
Now that's a problem that I can certainly help you with. You know, what do you do when someone is so annoying and horrible that they ruin everybody else's fun? Luckily, I have the answer, and I learned it from the biggest obnock in the whole world.
What's an obnock?
You should know.
Where do you think obnoxious comes from? Anyways, my scary Uncle Vladimir of the Transylvania Spoonapples tells a story about it every year at the Spoonapple Reunion Picnic.
Scary Uncle Vladimir?
From Transylvania?
It's a suburb of Cincinnati. He lives in a haunted house, only comes out at night, eats bugs, sleeps upside down, has a hook for a hand, and faints at the sight of my mother's garlic bread.
Why, hello, Edwina. Don't you look beautiful?
Why, hello, Uncle Vladimir. Won't you tell your scary story?
You mean the one about Frank, the obnoxious boy? Oh, no, that one's much too scary for you.
Tell it! Tell it!
Okay, gather round. Come and listen to a story of the strangest of nights in a faraway kingdom called Shaker Heights. Shelley Mary had a birthday that was coming to pass. She invited all the kids in her grade school class. The kids arrived at sundown with gifts in tow, and they started off the party with a puppet show. But just before the curtain came a knock at the door, you thought all the kids were there. But there was still one more.
Franking guess.
Open my present.
Franking guess.
When do we eat?
Franking guess.
I hate puppets.
He was a Franking guess. The party went on, and Frank was in top form. When they served the applesauce, he said,
I want mine warm.
When the hot dogs arrived, he said,
a hamburger, please. And I only eat my burgers with Limburger cheese.
And he shouted round the table,
I'm a waterfall.
And he spouted cherry Kool-Aid over one and all. When the ice cream was scooped, and they brought out the cake, he said,
I need the biggest piece. Plus one for my pet snake.
Frankengus. Frankengus.
Stop it. You're scaring him.
Frankengus.
You can swallow a guinea pig whole.
He was a Frankengus. What's the thing that makes him so offensive?
Seafood bleh.
What gives him that?
je ne sais quoi.
That means I don't know.
Is it 'cause the moon's so big? Was he born a total pig?
I don't know.
Let's ask his mom.
Frank was always a rambunctious child. A nice boy, I should mention. Please don't be mad. He's really not that bad. He just likes lots of attention.
So if you've got a friend like Frankie, just take my advice. I'll give you a cure that you won't need twice. If you pay him no attention when he acts like a jerk, then he'll find that being monstrous doesn't work. And he'll find before long the attention he craves will be his to enjoy if he just behaves. Frank and yes!
Where'd everybody go?
Frank and yes!
Hide and seek?
Frankenguest!
No loot bag?
He was a Frankenguest. Don't be a Frankenguest!
And to bring on the next letter, we have the resident prima ballerina of Miss Sandy's YMCA class. Please welcome Kelly Poskinozovich. Kelly, oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh, what?
You're not gonna believe it. Hey, Edwina, my life is a mess. I've got a problem and I'm under such stress. My grandson set the table and it's really not fair for, oh my gosh, all these utensils go who knows where. Can you help me out? I'm really in a quandary. At least I'm glad that grandma didn't make me do the laundry. Total true love, Carrie. A seriously perplexing problem. Billy, what would you do in this situation?
I got all the utensils I need right here.
Wrong answer. Annie, what about you?
I don't know, Edwina, but for my camping badge, I had to make a whole 5-course meal using only tinfoil, matches, and one branch.
Very impressive, but that doesn't answer Carrie's question. It is therefore, Carrie, that I, Edwina Spoonapple, simultaneously answer your question and end the first act of our show with the greatest finale of my latest opera, Ode to Oneida.
Chef Ludmila made a dinner that she hoped would be a winner, for she yearned to win the prize of Chef Extraordinaire. Call to her assistant, Mabel.
Mabel, time to set the table.
Looked around and up and down, but Mabel wasn't there. She said,
where is she? Where is she? Oh,
she said,
I'm going to cry. Without a set table, I'm going to cry and win no awards for my gooseberry.
Let's see. The contest states there are 3 parts: taste, originality, and really nice table setting. Oh, who will help me in my time of need?
It is I, your fairy folk mother, all the way from Cutlerania. You don't know how to set a table? Why, it's easy. William, Sonoma, lend me a hand.
Fork, 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 fork,
starting from the left. Take a little fork, it's a salad fork. Then you take a bigger fork and place it nicely to the front of that fork. Good. Then you take the plate, it's a lovely plate. Then you place the plate down right next to them. Line it up. Nice. Aren't you having the time of your life? And guess what comes next? The knife. Take the knife and go crusade in like so. One more thing to do. One spoon to the right and eureka, you're through. Now come along, try it with me.
Starting from the left, take the little fork, it's a solid fork, then knife. Find a bigger fork and place it nicely to the right of that fork. Then I take a plate, it's a lovely plate, and I place the plate down right next to them.
Line it up. That looks nice. Aren't you having the time of your life?
Yay!
And guess what comes next?
I think it's the knife.
Take the knife and go, cause I did. So one more thing to do.
One spoon to the right, and eureka, you're through.
Now look at this table, how lovely it's turned.
And if I don't win, well, look how much I've learned.
In just a few moments, the judges arrive.
It's all set?
But we need 65!
Oh dear, hurry up! From the left, take a little fork, it's a solid fork. Then you take a bigger fork and place it next to the right. That fork, good. Then plate, it's a lovely plate. Then you place the plate down right next to them. Line it up. That looks nice. Aren't you having the time of your life? And guess what comes next? Well, you guessed it, the knife. Take the knife and go, cause it ain't so. One more thing to do, let's go to the right, and eureka, you do.
The table was lovely, the guests had a ball. Ludmila was chosen the best chef of all. And as they crowned her chef extraordinaire, she said, now I know just where to put the soup.
Can you believe it? It's time for intermission. Can you believe it? Sit back, relax. You're all invited to Kelly's Lemonade Stand. Let's all have some snacks.
That's right, everybody. Don't forget to come on down to Kelly's Lemonade Stand during our 5-minute intermission. I don't know. I think it's that woman by the waiting pool.
Will you read the letter now, Edwina?
Scott, it will have to wait.
What if it's an emergency?
What could be so important that it can't wait until next week?
But Edwina...
That girl by the waiting pool? No. She's my troop leader.
Vanderpluk 1, we need an usher report. Do you copy?
Vanderpluk 1, we've got some box office overflow. Do you have anything we can use to rectify the situation?
Vanderpluk 2, we're looking at two deck chairs, an office chair, a lawn chair, and a sit-in spin.
Bring it on out.
That's a copy.
That's a copy on your copy.
What about that guy over there? He's smiling and applauding.
No, that's my cheerleading coach. What about that lady over there?
Which one?
The one with the Kalamazoo Advice of Palooza Festival baseball cap on.
That can't be her. She's...
sleeping!
And we're back.
More letters for Edwina. Here come more letters. Let's see what's new. Here come more letters. More letters for Edwina. Welcome to Act Two. Welcome to Act Two.
Don't be blue, Periwinkle, Hergenberg, and Jurgensen. I've got the perfect song for you about the importance of saying hello. I mean, what's more important than saying hello?
Lovely Lima in Peru. Lola had a cousin Harry way out west in Honolulu. One day Lola got a letter from her cousin way out west.
If you'd come to my birthday party, Lola, that would be the best.
So on an airplane Lola flew all the way from Lima, Peru, far across the ocean blue, flew Lola from Lima to Honolulu.
And Harry's family said,
Hola, Lola, Lola, hello. Hola, Lola, hello. Hola, Lola, Lola, hello. Hola, Lola, hello.
They're at Harry's birthday party, as the children laughed and played. Cake was served by Harry's mom, but under a palm tree Lola stayed. Harry said to Lola,
Lola, why not come and say hello?
Nadia aquí habla mi idioma. They're all talking words I don't know. And Harry said,
now don't be shy, come to the table for pineapple pie. Everyone will welcome you, sweet Lola from Lima to Honolulu. Just say,
Hola, Lola, Lola, hello. Hola, Lola, hello. Hola, Lola, Lola, hello. Hola, Lola, hello.
Lola sat down at the table, set up in the island sand. Softly Lola whispered,
Hola,
hoping the kids would understand. Lola closed her eyes and swallowed, fearing that the worst would come. But all the kids took ukuleles, and everyone began to strum. And they all sang,
Hola, Lola, Lola, hello. Hola, Lola, hello. Hola,
makes you wake up and take notice.
H-E-double-L-O, good manners are the way to go.
Thank you, Becky, for that impromptu performance.
Go, 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 fight, fight, fight. You'll always win if you're polite.
You done yet?
Hey, you, sleeping in the chair. We're singing our guts out, don't you care?
Moving on. Let's see what's next, shall we?
Here's the next letter, Edwina.
Why, look at this. A letter from the Irish exchange student living in the McCoy's basement for the summer, Seamus McQuackenflacken.
Edwina, Edwina, I'm totally confused. I need the definition for a phrase I've never used. Upon an invitation is the word RSVP. I know it must be English, but it sure sounds Greek to me. I'd ask me older sister, she doesn't have a clue. Me folks are off in Scotland, so I thought that I'd ask you. That is all I have to say. Toodaloodaloodalay, wishing you a bonny day. Seamus.
That is no wee problem, Seamus McQuackenflacken. In fact, it takes a big laddie to admit when he doesn't understand the definition of something, especially when it is as important as party invitations. You know, I was just discussing this the other day with my cousin from France, Jean-Pierre Fromage de la Croissant.
Bonjour, Edwina. It's really lovely to see you.
Why, Fromage de la Croissant, don't you have a story to help out our friend?
But of course. You know my friend Henri, he's turning 10, you see. His mother thought, a cake, yes, I will bake it. And so a little note to all his friends she wrote, the party's Friday night, hope you can make it. So this note she sent, and through the mail it went, and ha ha ha. Found its way to me, and then I chanced to gaze upon a strange looking phrase, RSVP. I said to mother, mother, what is RSVP? And this is what my mother said to me. Répondez-vous play, it is a fancy way for saying save the day. And please reply. Pick up the phone, hello, you coming, we, no, you cannot, cannot show, thank you, goodbye. Répondez-y, vous play, you must know what to say when invites come your way, so don't be shy. You must respond with haste, there is no time to waste. I'll tell you, I'm sure Henri's mother make a nice and quiet dinner. Or should she set up 20 places for a feast? Should the ice cream scoops be smaller? Should she make the cupcakes taller? Or add more sprinkles at the very least? Will they have enough contestants for Red Rover? Or will they partake in a small game of croquet? Should they hire ballet dancers? Only you provide the answers when you répondez-vous play. Répondez-vous play, it is a fancy way for saying, say, hey, hey, you must reply. For Henri's mother sweet, she must know what to eat, how much baguette to eat, and what to buy. Répondez-vous play, you will attend, hooray! You cannot come, a very sad, sad song. It at first might be queasy, but good etiquette is easy. Just give it a try, just give it a try. So my friend, pick up the phone, write a letter of your own. Tell Henri, your little friend, I will attend. Poor Maria's second bed, her seven sisters come and sit. Chairs and tables by the dozen, don't forget the 20 cousins. All the neighbors down the street, now the party is complete. Is the table going to break? Better make another cake. So now you know what's right. You're très polite. After all, would I lead you astray? You'll be thought of as most pleasant, even if you can't be present when you répondez-vous play. Everybody, RSVP, répondez-vous play. Hey! Ah, mademoiselle. Your beauty is like a Parisian perfume.
Get away from you, creep.
I think you mean crepe, no?
Au revoir, Jean-Pierre.
Now, where were we?
I think you should read this one next.
Scott, I told you. Next week.
Alex?
Oh, no.
Edwina. Dear Edwina.
Say by the L.
Edwi. Dear Edwi, dear Edwi, dear Edwi, dear Edwi, dear Edwina. I
I'm Ziggy Montego from 727 Belafonte Street. I'd like to introduce you to my steel drum band.
Won't you help us, dear Edwina?
We got a little problem and we'll hope you'll lend a hand.
Won't you help us, dear Edwina?
There's a big steel drummer right down in Jamaica where it's sunny.
Won't you help us, dear Edwina?
And our marching band can go if we can raise the ticket money.
Won't you help us, dear Edwina?
We had a little bake sale, we washed a lot of cars. We had a little telethon, we sold some candy bars. But before we could say deal, we had earned us everything. But they had a sale on Game Boys, and now our money's spent. Edwina, dear Edwina, won't you help us? We don't want to stay home.
Now, this is a problem I can certainly relate to. It's important to save for a rainy day, and when I forget how important it is, I sing myself a little tune taught to me by my 15th cousin twice removed, Mary Sue Betty Bob Spoonapple. Why, Betty Bob, is that you?
Shona.
You must be on your way to the Michigan State Fair. Won't you come up and introduce yourself to the folks?
Howdy, Ma. Howdy, Pa. Howdy, Pa.
Why, Betty Bob, I used to love that song you'd play me on your banjo. Now, how'd that little tune go?
If you look inside your wallet or your bank book or your purse and you find, how shall we say, the cupboard's bare, there's a lesson you should follow that at first is hard to swallow, but in time you'll learn to use with style and flair.
Style and flair.
It's a lesson that I learned from all my years down on the farm in the rolling cornfield out in Illinois. Farmer Jerry said to me, if you're off to the city, here's a piece of farm advice you should employ. See!
Put it in the piggy. Put it in the piggy. Spending. There'll be a happy ending. You have lots and lots of money. If you lose me, honey, put it in the piggy with me.
For example, if you're holding your allowance in your hand and you're passing by your favorite candy store,
favorite store,
so you're saving for a baseball glove you've wanted all year long, you can see those jujubes you just adore.
Yeah.
And you go up to the countertop and to yourself you say, I deserve these jujubes, I really do.
Of course you do.
A vision may appear, it's Farmer Jerry loud and clear saying, I would put them back if I were you. What the heck's a jujube?
Put it in the piggy.
You really need that.
Put it in the piggy.
I don't think so.
If you do, your life will be less piggy. Piggy, piggy, piggy. If you want to start a little stash out. If you're big, 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 big. That's a really lovely sweater. Let's go out and see a show. All the girls are meeting for a miniature golf, and we really, really want you to know.
Don't forget, your friends at the farm. But it's gonna cost you a leg and an arm. Pick the things you want the most, or your savings will be toast.
Put it in the piggy. Put it in the piggy. If you do, your savings will be piggy. Piggy, piggy, piggy. If you watch spending,
no, spend like a dork.
There'll be a happy ending.
Eliminate pork.
You have lots and lots of money if you list me, honey, and you put it in the piggy with me.
Ham it up.
Put it in the piggy with me.
Now you're bacon.
Put it in the piggy with me.
Now here comes the pig finish.
Well, that's our show for today, everybody. Let's give a hand to the newest member. member of the Spoon Apple Repertory Theater all the way from the beautiful city of Kansas City, Mo.
St. Louis.
St. Louis, Mo. Welcome my new neighbor and best friend, Bobby...
Newsome.
Bobby, is there anything you'd like to say to your new public?
Gosh, there's so many people I'd like to thank, starting from the ones all the way below that helped me get all the way to the top.
Hit it!
Thanks for coming, it's really great to see you. Thanks for coming to our little show. We hope to see you next week at Dear Edwina. Now it's time to go.
The show's not over. There's one more letter.
We did all the numbers already.
I think you should read it.
We have a letter here from Scott. Anonymous?
Dear Edwina, I've got girl problems. I carved her a heart in Dad's wood shop, but it came out like a blob. I made a sign that said, please be mine, out of kernels from corn on the cob. Every night I take out my telescope, and I wish on the asteroids that soar, that someday I'll get noticed by the girl that I adore. And I know you think it's stupid, but I'm writing just the same. To ask you what a boy should do when the whole world is shouting her name. Edwina. Edwina. I'm dreaming of a bike ride and a milkshake shared by two. Oh, Edwina, you're the one. What can I do?
Scott, we'll talk about this later.
The heart doesn't know the word later.
Doesn't know the word dork.
Tease me all you want. I'm in love and I don't care who knows it.
Scott, we all know it.
The whole neighborhood knows it.
Knows what?
Can't we talk about this tomorrow?
No, I will not be denied. I doodle your name in my notebook in my summer school chemistry class. And the next time my lawn needs mowing, I'm carving your name in the grass. Now that my secret's free, wonder what will be. Will you tell me to go fly a kite? Or will you share the feelings in the letter that I write? And I know you think it's stupid, and you might not care at all. But every time I watch the birds, I hear all the sapsuckers call, Edwina. Edwina. As chairman of the chess club, I ask, won't you be my queen, dear Edwina, my dear Edwina, the most beautiful, marvelous, wonderful girl I've seen, oh Edwina, you, me, Dairy Queen.
Well, thanks for coming, it's really great to see you. Well, thanks for coming to our little show. We hope to see you next week at Dear Edwina. Now it's time to go. Now it's time to go.
Hold Edwina's calls. Hello? Who is this?
and Van Buren to the Kalamazoo Advice Palooza Festival? I'm sorry. We're not taking any calls right now.
Speakerphone! Speakerphone!
Why, thank you.
In fact, I think we found a spot for you in the Kalamazoo Advice Palooza Festival. What talent!
Wow!
Oh, passion!
Yeah!
What a range!
Yeah!
Scott, you'll be just perfect to sing the national anthem at the opening ceremonies.
Scott? But what about the rest of us?
Oh, that's all we need for this year, honey.
What about Dr. Joyce Brothers' last-minute cancellation?
We got a new group in from Montreal, Advice du Soleil.
Advice du Soleil?
They all stand on each other's heads. It's fabulous.
I'm not going anywhere without my beloved Edwina.
Now, Scott, we have a million things to do.
No!
We've got a meeting tomorrow with the Detroit Free Press.
No!
And we have to discuss what you're going to wear to the gala opening.
No!
Of course, Jennifer Lopez will back you up on the national anthem.
Really?
I'll have my assistant swing by the Dairy Queen in 15 minutes to pick you up.
Come with me, Edwina.
You go ahead, Scott. We'll always have Papa.
Don't worry, Edwina.
It's a great show.
Chin up, kid.
We still had fun.
The dance must go on.
Brownies?
Oh, what's the point? Up on the fridge, how I long for the day I can point to the door and say, gee, there's Katie and Myra and Myra and Myra and Joe.
Oh, who wants to go to stupid old Kalamazoo anyway?
Katie? Leave me alone. Katie Spoonapple, what are you doing here? Aren't you supposed to be at the Math Summer Olympics?
I ran away.
What do you mean you ran away? You can't just run away.
Who cares about a gold medal in trigonometry anyway?
You do. It's been your specialty since third grade.
I'm never doing another math equation for as long as I live.
Whoa, whoa, back up.
Well, we were getting ready for the multiplication trials, and Sally's Farnworth was next to me. And next to her was Mary Kay Hooper.
Isn't that the girl you beat out for the All-State Math Division Championship?
Yeah. Anyway, she and Sally became super best friends for the week. And as we finished our equations, I happened to finish first.
Of course you did.
And as I brought my answers to the judge, everyone clapped. But then Sally whispered, "I hate that girl, Kate. She thinks she's so great."
And you heard her?
Everyone did.
You sure you didn't imagine it? No? All I can say is that for a bunch of math champions, those girls sound pretty stupid.
Just forget it.
Hey.
All I want to know is, when do I get my best friend for the week?
Oh, Katie. Those kids that try and knock you down, they're not what life's about. Just learn to sing your special song and drown them out. I won't pretend it doesn't hurt. Some things kids say can hurt a lot. But what hurts more is when they make you want to be something you're not. You've got to sing your own song. Use your own voice. Your voice is not a thing to be afraid of. And when they hear it ring true, there's not a thing they can't do to take away the music that you're made of. Oh, to be normal, to be a safe and unassuming shade of gray. Not too different, not too smart. No more poems in your heart. Do you really want to live your life that way? You better see if Joe can drive you back to the Olympic Village before Mom and Dad get home.
I'm gonna win a gold for you.
And even if you don't, that's okay too.
You know, you give the best advice ever.
I do?
Yeah. I don't know what I'd do without you?
But the town scout only wanted Scott. She didn't take my advice.
Gee, Edwina, I think it looks like you didn't take it either.
For those who work so very hard to make their talents fly, it's hard when what gives so much joy can make you cry.
But hold on tight to who you are.
Don't lose that joy to please the crowd.
And if they still don't understand, you'll have to sing a little louder.
Just sing your own song. Use your own voice. Your voice is not a thing to be afraid of. And when they hear it ring true, there's not a thing they can do to take away the music that you're made of.
Don't let them take away the music that you're made of. There's no invitation to put on the fridge, no ribbon to point to with pride. And I like big fat A's, but what A can compare to the feeling I'm feeling inside? And what's more important than a hug from your sis, or the fact that your friends had a ball? Don't think about prizes. Just do what you love.
What's that, Grandma? You just got 5 minutes left on the videotape? I think it's time for an encore. Come on, everybody, sing!
Cheerio, ciao, Lola, ni hao.
colleagues Dan, Mike, and Michael for the set design and our wonderful garage setup back here. We have Max Sinclair as our stage manager. Jen Tassetti Fuller as our choreographer. Sixth graders helping with the lighting. Matt Matei as our overall